might be surpassing each and everything in this world, but it is not the case. So we need to scope out the project. We need to set up the boundaries. We need to define what is this current project is going to speak about. What is the solution that you are going to provide? What are the items that you are going to address? And what are the items you are not going to consider? Out of scope functionality. So that is the in scope functionality and out of scope functionality. Some say this term interchangeably they use current scope and then scope out. Okay. So, okay, we will take the same example that we discussed just now. The insurance project. So, what is the scope? What are the items that we are going to prepare? Or what is the solution that our project is going to provide?
Since it is an insurance company, the insurance plans to the customers and all.
Okay, so that is more general. So when you say, yeah, you are right, but from the system point of view, when we are speaking, what we are going to give? A centralized portal application, wherein the agency users will be able to log in if they have the valid credentials. That is one thing.
So yes.
As you stated, once the agency user logs in, we'll provide also the list of policies that are available. Based on the customized need of the users, we can select any of the plans. Okay. The third one is, yeah, after entering all the basic details, the user is supposed to also view. So before we take any insurance policies, what we do, we try to find out what is the premium, right?
Yes.
Okay, so we are not going to finalize the policy unless and until we are fine with the premium. So a draft version of the policy, what we say, it as a quotation. So we key in all the information, try to calculate the premium, and then get a quotation out of it. Though we are not getting the hard copy of the quotation, the insurance advisor will show you, you know, after entering all these details, yeah, okay, this is how your policy will be, and these are the terms and conditions, and this is the premium that is being calculated, and this is the debris. For example, if it is a two-wheeler or if it is four-wheeler that you are going to take insurance, you will say your model of the vehicle is 2005 and now this is 2018. So for 1 year we are going for the policy. These are the chassis number detail, your vehicle number detail, vehicle model number, vehicle model detail, all these things here is going to enter at last. What we are concerned, much concerned, is about what is the depreciation value he is going to give. What is the value, ID value of the item? Say, for example, 4 lakhs. Okay. Then, if he is saying the depreciation value, the current value of this vehicle is 4 lakhs. For this 4 lakhs, what is the premium he is going to say? Say, for example, 4,500 rupees. After applying discount, after applying, you know, no claim bonus and all other previous stuff. So after entering everything, say for example, 5,900 was the original case. Now after reduction, after applying the discount, it is 4,600. Then plus GST or plus VAT, some taxes, comes to 4,900. So now we are concerned about, much concerned about the premium, because that is the amount that we are going to pay. So in order to do that, the system must generate a simple quotation and show to the user. So if the user wants to make any changes, he can make the changes into the quotation, and finally he can submit the policy. So these are all the scopes. So our application is trying to have a login credential. Our application is supposed to show the list of policies that are available. Our application is supposed to capture the basic information of the insured party or the insured item. Then it should calculate the risk, to what are the risks that is being covered, and it should calculate the premium. Based on the premium calculator, and then if it is finalized, it should go for quotation. Once the quotation is finalized, then it should generate a policy. Okay, so this is the scope. Now, once the policy is generated, once the policy is generated. So now you agreed you and your software company, that is your software company and your vendor has agreed to deliver such a product. Okay. Now, during discussion and everything is finalized, now the software, the vendor comes and say that, you know, I want to send notification. So once the policy is purchased, I want to send notification to the end user who is purchasing the insured policy, which was not discussed here, right? We have not discussed in this case. When we are scoping in the functionality, various functionality, we have not discussed about the notification, or we have not discussed about sending a copy to the customer. So notification, you can send it either way. It is going to be a SMS that you are going to send along with also an email to the insured party. So those things are not captured. So you must be clear that, you know, what are the scope that you are going to cover within the project. Okay.
Okay.
So that is what the functionality, that these are the functionalities that are being available within this particular project you need to say. And what is not covered here, say the related items. So in this case, say for example, the policy printing, whether it is a stationary or it is going to be a white paper or a regular paper. So stationary, when I say, you have a pre-printed form. Upon the pre-printed form, only the user details will be captured. I am saying about the hard copy. So user details will be captured and printed. So whether stationary item is going to be used as a one of the case. So then, if it is being shared, what is the frequency at which, say, the email is sent to the user, similarly message is sent to the user. So these are the two types of notifications. Now the vendor company comes to you and says that, you know, before 20 days of expiry date, you need to get a notification. Say for example, I have taken a policy and which is going to end by April 30th. Okay. So on April 10th or April 15th, certain notifications need to be sent as a reminder to the user so that he gets the business back. So every year he is going to get the business. So such type of notifications which was not discussed. So those items, you those items that are not discussed during the project scope and the kickoff, so those items you need to discuss in the out of scope. Okay.
Okay.
So even yesterday also I showed you about, from the system perspective, what are the items that we are going to, you know, we will have some assumptions, we will have some constraints, what is the risk involved within the project. Even with the user document that I shown you yesterday, we will have always these assumptions. Say for example, what is the assumption in this case of the insurance project that we discussed? Can you see? Okay. Or else, can we have the second example that I told you, right? So in this case, what is the assumption?
In the insurance case?
Yeah, whatever might be. We have discussed two examples, right? Say for example, in the application, the second one I say, a gaming application or any application is available. Now the user wants to capture the user profile as a separate section. So that particular piece of project that you are going to work on. So in that case, what is the assumption? Okay. So what is the assumption is the system is already, the application is already in place and they have multiple users using the application. So that is the assumption. So all the users with the valid credentials can log into the application, can use their application. Okay. So those are the assumptions that you have. So these things are already in place. You are stating that you're building upon or you are working on a new piece of product, new feature of the product that is going to be added up or patched up to the existing system. So you say that these things are already in place. Okay.
Okay.
Constraints. So these are the, handling the exceptions, that is a constraint. Handling the error messages, that's a constraint. Then what is the timing that you are going to execute this project? So those are the constraints. Any dependency. So in this case of the application that I told you, so a mobile app. So what is the constraint? If it has got any dependency, okay. So any dependency within the project, or any dependency which is going to. So when you say that, what is the? So if an application is rolling out some new feature, okay, when you are trying to see your Play Store, App Store, or Google Play Store, so you will always get a notification that it needs to be updated, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so that particular notification has to be sent to each and every user who has got the application on their mobile. So such type of items we need to include here. Then from the system point of view, okay, from the system point of view, what is the constraint is, if it has got some dependencies, who are the players into the, or who are the stakeholders within the application, so they need to be any changes that are going to impact any approval levels of constraints. So all these things we can list it out. This may be system wise or operational wise or execution wise, what are the constraints that you have, you need to mention. Okay. So risk. Kavya, hearing?
Yes.
Okay. So risk, basically, this is the project manager's call. But see, you include that particular case. So any risk involved, So what are the, generally speaking, what are the risks involved? If you are not able to go with the, project timeline. So say your project is for, 120 man hours. And you are trying to, by end of the 120 hours, you cannot say we need additional of 40 hours. So there is some risk involved in it, definitely, and this risk should not go beyond certain level. Do you understand?
Okay.
Your project deadline is, say for example, 140 hours. It is not necessary that you wait till 140 hours and then end of the 140 hours, you say that, I need additional of 40 hours. That is not the case. You will be envisioning, say, as the project progresses. Say you started on April 15th and your deadline of delivery to the QA. Okay, we are speaking only on this term. Say you have a development, from development to QA, from QA to QA to UAT, UAT to the production. Okay.
Okay.
Now your development task has to be completed. Though you are not responsible for the development, but it is the business analyst who is going to drive the entire project. Okay, it's going to be within your control. So if you are able to envision, say you started on April 15th, on April 20 you will have certain deliverables, ensure that those deliverables are there. On April 25th you will have certain deliverables, and you are supposed to end the development activity on April 30th. Okay, now any deviation from this, say you have various benchmarks, right? Say for example 15 to 20, so 5 days, 20 to 25, 10 days, 25 to 30, 15 days. So end of day 5, you see all the deliverable items are available or not. If not available, check with the development team if they need more resources, or check with the development team if they need more time in order to develop, what is stopping them from delivering the item. What is the issue with the delivering the accepted items? You're not forcing them to do what is out of scope, but you're forcing them to do, or you are trying to facilitate them. Instead of saying the forcing, you can use the term facilitating them in order to provide, you're motivating the team in order to provide the accepted deliverables. Okay, so now end of day 5, say for example on April 20th, you see that out of 5 deliverables, only 3 are delivered. Okay, now you can envision, okay, certain things are going wrong. So now when you discuss with the development team, they say that, we have estimated it, estimation what we are did is far exceeding the actual scenario. So then that is the reason we have delivered. So it means that they need more hours. Now once again you re-estimate the project and then discuss with the project manager and then come to a agreed upon term that you need further more hours. These further more hours, how can you accommodate? Can you see?
Yeah. Yes, Abdul.
Yeah. See, when the development team says that they need another 20 hours, because the estimation that what they did was not matching the actual case. And they say that we need another 20 or 40 hours in order to complete these deliverables. How are we going to take it up?
No idea.
Okay. Now this is the question that will be put to you. There are two ways to handle it. But either way, your management will say, we are not going to change any deliverable dates. Okay?
Okay.
April 30th, dot, it has to be delivered to QA. May 5th, it has to be delivered to UAT. May 20th is the rollout to the production. Okay? These tight deadlines, you are working on always when we work on projects, we are working on tight deadlines only. Because we are more focused on the customer point of view and we don't want to disappoint the customer on the delivery dates. So what is the only way you can do? So if some additional hours are needed, obviously we will say that okay, we can extend the project for another 2 to 3 days. But when we work on the tight deadlines, this is not the solution. What is the other solution you can have? Say for example, in the development team, currently there are two resources working. Okay, so for them, it is not possible to deliver as accepted the deliverable. So in that case, what you are trying to do is, you can pull in another ad hoc developer from other projects and try to include. So when we pull a resource, it means that we are utilizing another resource. So within the schedule, we are trying to complete, but at the same time, additional hours also provided to the development team. Got it?
Okay.
So it's usually a project manager's task, but you know, business analyst will also have a say on this, like, you know, because these are the agreed terms with the client and then we don't have, you know, additional hours to be provided still. But because this is being committed from our end, we need to take it up. So the only way of alternate solution that you can provide is this. So likewise only, so now in this case, so actually we started with the problem. What is the problem is, we cannot say that on the end of the date of delivery, we cannot say that certain more hours are needed to us. So it is only, we need to envision it as the project progresses. So by 20th itself, you find on April 20th itself, you find that even, you know, there is some deviation from the deliverable. So you try to mitigate the items and then, you know, try to find the solution at that point. And then, so to ensure that the process is smooth, and you are still on time for the April 30th delivery. Got it?
Okay.
Remember, I told you, like, so the next topic would be like, you know, the business process review. I told you, we always record as is done. The very first day of our demo, I discussed about this, you know, as is to be. Okay?
Okay.
So as is recording the, it is basically when a business analyst go for a system study. He straight away goes to the, so in the insurance project that we discussed, what he is supposed to do? He is supposed to discuss with the agency users and then record whatever activity, business activity he does on a day-to-day basis. Okay, so that is the assets. Got it?
Okay.
A routine day-to-day business activity. So in this case, what are the items that are involved? The agency user himself, then the system in which he is working, then who are the other items who are involved? The insured party who is coming to get the insurance. Okay. So these are the user and the system, the actors and the system who are involved in the current process or the current business. So that is, we record it as assets.
Okay.
Then to be is the solution approach that you are going to provide. To be is the solution.